time, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps as we honor America and the brave men and women who protect our freedoms with the singing of our national anthem by Rouse High School choir member Ashley Kaiser.
Oh,
this is NCAA college basketball featuring the Waves of Pepperdine University. Today's Waves cast is a production of the Pepperdine University Department of Athletics, internet service provided by Stretcher Audio. Well, a pleasant good afternoon, everyone, from HEB Center in Cedar Park, Texas. I'm Al Epstein. by Idris Taki. Down low to Reyes right side, and he gets called for traveling. Well, the officials really looking for the traveling call, at least at the start of the season. His officials from the Big 12, Kevin Mathis, Kirby Sitton, and Jeff Melham. As the Bonnies come in the front court, moving right to left. Bonnie's another high-scoring team. They average 81 a game, allowing 74. Pepperdine, the man defense. And Major does a nice job on Adams to Mobley. At 28 last night against Central Michigan. Mobley with the dribble, going to the key and deep, throw it up and missed the shot. Rebound fought for. Helms dives on the floor, and we got bodies and the ball's tied up. Taki was right there. Alternating possession on the tie-up. It will be Pepperdine ball. Pepperdine comes in. They've scored well at the start. 75 points a game. They allow 74. Where they have struggled is at the free throw line, only 59%. For the Bonnies, they shoot 71% at the line. Bonnies are a very good rebounding team. Plus two on the year. Pepperdine also a plus two on the boards. Left side it goes to Helens in the corner. His three-pointer is long off the rim. Ball tipped and taken by Ayane from Nigeria, but he lost it out of bounds, and Pepperdine will get it. Waves in their blue, orange, and white uniforms. The Bonnies in their white and brown. Touch of silver. And so Pepperdine will get a new shot clock. 4-2 St. Bonaventure, 17-19 to play before halftime. Lamont Moore with the dribble, pull up, 16-foot jump shot hits the rim. Rebound grab. This is Mobley in the front court, dribbling to the key in the corner. This is Taki's three-pointer's good. Idris Taki. So Taki knocking down the shot, and it's 7-2 St. Bonaventure. They've got 102 points against Central Michigan yesterday. Very impressive against a good Chippewa team that was unbeaten 4-0. This is Jeremy Major. Major top of the circle, 16 points last night. Dribble in deep, throw up a short jumper, hits the rim and grabbed by Mobley. Mobley out of the backcourt. Mobley left side of Taki, driving, lays it up and in. Taki with the lay-in, 9-2 St. Bonaventure. As coming out of the backcourt, Jeremy Major. Waves have shot well in this tournament, both games over 50%. For the season, they're 49%. And St. Bonaventure comes in, shooting 47% from the field, but they're off to a great start. Helms left side, ball tipped out of bounds by Adams and Pepperdine ball. I think about Jalen Adams. He's such a terrific offensive player. He also leads the Bonnies with 11 steals on the season. He was the top shooter in the Atlantic 10 last year in three-point shots, better than 44%. 4 seconds on the shot clock, down to two. Murray's got to put it up. He won't get it away. 30-second shot clock violation against Pepperdine. As we get a timeout, 9-2 St. Bonaventure, 15:56 to go before halftime. Well, the Waves off to a cold start, and St. Bonaventure off the dribble, getting some good penetration. And St. Bonaventure on a 7-0 run over the last 2 minutes and 38 seconds, and the Waves unable to score in 2 minutes and 48 seconds and no field goals during that time. While you're listening to Wavescast, Pepperdine Athletics would like to extend its thanks to the following businesses for their support this season. The Parking Spot, Coca-Cola, Gold Coast Tours, Dukes of Malibu, the Warner Center Marriott, the Anza Calabasas Hotel, Chick-fil-A, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, National Rent-A-Car, Primetime Shuttle, and Wells Fargo. And Pepperdine would like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of Pepperdine men's basketball. 7-0 run for the Bonnies, high-scoring team. St. Bonaventure, located about 60 miles south of Buffalo in the county of Olean, population about 10,000. The university enrollment is under 2,000, about 1,600. And they are picked fifth in the Atlantic 10 this year. Dayton is picked number one with Rhode Island number two, but the Bonnies are the defending conference champions. They tied for first last season, 14-4. and 22-9 overall. They did not win their tournament, so they ended up in the NIT and lost in the first round to Wagner. Pepperdine, out of the West Coast Conference, is picked fourth behind Gonzaga, St. Mary's, and Brigham Young. Waves winning 18 games and losing 14, finishing in fourth, 10-8. And again, they are picked fourth once again. They went to the CBI tournament last year, lost in the first round at Eastern Washington. Waves start the game 1 of 7, 14%. St. Bonaventure, 4 of 6, 67%. Rebounding 6-2 Pepperdine. 4 on the offensive glass, but no putbacks. Will be St. Bonaventure ball. Now Matt Mobley from Central Connecticut State leads this Bonnie's team with 15 threes. The Waves go into a zone. Right side, Adams in the corner. Mobley, right side, 19-foot jumper, no good. Rebound inside by Greg. Back to Mobley. His 22-footer is good. Matt Mobley knocking down the shot. His 16th three-pointer of the year. The two outside guns for the Bonnies are Adams and Mobley. And the fact that Mobley shoots 47% behind the arc, major inside to Guerin, who lays it in. Nate Guerin just into the lineup. 6'10", redshirt sophomore out of Waukee, Iowa. Been playing very well. And a nice job yesterday against Little Rock. And all four teams are so good. Adams on the right wing launches up a three that is off the mark. Rebound grabbed and Jeremy Major in the front court. 12-4 as we get a whistle and a foul away from the ball. It'll be a legal screen against Pepperdine. It'll be on Nate Guerin. One on him. First team foul against the Waves. And they also call a technical foul on Nate Guerin. So if he gets a personal and a technical, that means he's got two personal fouls and the second team foul, and going to the line will be Jalen Adams. Last year, 87% at the line, and he knocks it down the first one. Adams this season just 72% at the free throw line. He does have 9 threes, and the next one is good. So Adams converts both free throws. And St. Bonaventure will have possession near midcourt, leading 14-4. And so the Waves are off to a very slow start in this one. A 12-2 run for St. Bonaventure over the last 3 minutes, 3:37. Waves are in a zone of 2-3. Murray and Major up top. This is Taki dribbling along the baseline. Jumper by Ianni is good. Well, the Waves being issued a warning. Pepperdine's been called for a couple of traveling violations. And Marty Wilson really unhappy about the officiating throughout the whole tournament. So the basket is good by Ianni. And the Waves down 16-4 with 14:34 to play before halftime. Craig Lassen checks in for Pepperdine, 6'9 freshman from Sweden. Left side, Murray dribbling along the baseline. Fall away, jumper is short. Rebound taken by Reyes. Powers his way up. The shot goes in and counts his foul. Chris Reyes. Basket is good. Foul's going to be on Chinonzo Obiko, a 6'9 senior from Nigeria. So Reyes has 4 points. Waves have been struggling at the free throw line, but Reyes comes in averaging just under 16 points and 8 rebounds a game. And the free throw good by Reyes. He has 5 of the 7. So 16-7, St. Bonaventure. Reyes on the year only shooting 46% at the line, but from the field, 72%. He came into the game 34-47. Elijah Lee into the game for Pepperdine. Very quick guard out of Houston. Elijah Lee, 5'10", right side Mobley, fires up a three, is good from the right wing. Matt Mobley from 22 feet out. It is 19-7, St. Bonaventure. Elijah Lee Dribbles to the right side against that man defense of St. Bonaventure. Major in the lane underneath to Reyes. Puts it up. Shot blocked from behind by Greg. Picked up by Lassen. Tries to take it up and is fouled.
Good job.
I'll be on Jalen Adams. Number one on him. First team foul against the Bonnies. 19-7. Pepperdine down. 13:43 to go. Lassen, who played on Sweden's junior national team. He was a starting point guard, but then grew about 5 inches, and all of a sudden he's become a wing player, but very athletic player. Has done a nice job for Pepperdine in his first year. He played his high school basketball in Maryland. Free throw is good by Lassen. He makes both. 19-9, Pepperdine down, 13:40 to play. There's Adams front court. The daring Griffin checks in. For the Bonnies, the Waves stay in a 2-3 zone. Adams top of the circle to Mobley. Left side to Greg. 12 on the shot clock. Mobley right side. Dribbles in the lane. Give it off inside to Obico with the ball tipped away by Reyes. Pepperdine comes up with a stop. And Murray in the front court. It's going to be a high-scoring game if St. Bonaventure likes the tempo. But the Waves have the ability to score a lot of points. Elijah Lee in deep to Lassandra. Shot off the glass doesn't go, but we get a foul inside.
Hey,
going to be against Chris Reyes of Pepperdine. One on him. Three team fouls against Pepperdine.
Stay with it. Go.
Pepperdine University located in Malibu along the Pacific Coast Highway. You can see the Pacific Ocean. 19-9, St. Bonaventure. 12:55 to go. This is Denzel Gregg, co-sixth man of the year in the Atlantic 10 last year. Deep in the corner, a three-pointer by Mobley is off the mark. Murray's got it for Pepperdine. Murray front court, dribble inside, lost the handle, and the ball picked up by Ianni. Front court to Mobley. Right side to Adams on the wing. His 22-footer, no good. Reyes has it for Pepperdine. In the front court to Major. Major left side. Hey, Bonaventure quick to get back in transition with their defense. Elijah Lee back to Major on the right wing. Guarded by Mobley. Major dribble in the lane. In deep. Tries to take it up and draws the foul. Nice job by Jeremy Major initiating the contact. The foul will be on Ianni. One on him. Second team foul. And Jeremy Major will be at the line shooting two. Just 50% on the season. He's averaging 9 points a game. He is number three all-time in career assists. Coming into the game with 395, tying Doug Christie. Major makes the free throw. And the Waves down, fortunately, only 19-10. Next one is good. Pepperdine making their free throws. They have struggled quite a bit. Major comes out and knocks Helms back in. Mentioned Craig Lassen's been playing well. He's averaging 7 points and 6 rebounds a game and shooting better than 58% from the floor. 6'9 freshman still in the lineup. The Waves in that 2-3. It's kind of forced the Bonnies to make some shots outside. Griffin in the lane, 14-foot jumper bounces off. Helen has it for Pepperdine. 11:52 to play in the first half. Hey, Bonaventure 19, Pepperdine 11. In the corner, Murray, his three-point shot is good. Lamont Murray, deep in the left corner, knocking down the three. 19-14, the Waves trail by five. In the front court, Griffin, right side, goes to Greg. Waves double along the baseline, out to Adams. He's open, a three-pointer shot, no good. Tip by Annie, no good. Ball goes out of bounds to the Waves. We get a timeout. 11 minutes, 26 seconds to go. St. Bonaventure 19 and Pepperdine 14. The Bonnies losing to Little Rock in the first game of this tournament, 68-65, and then, as we mentioned, really rolled past Central Michigan, 102-71, against a good Central Michigan team. St. Bonaventure already had a tough game at Florida, and you knew they would be pretty good this year when they played the Gators very tough on the road, 73-66, back on November 17th. Last year, the Bonnies were 9-6 on the road. They are 2-1 currently this year. Waves 1-1 away from home and 8-11 last season. But the Waves fortunate to be down just by a couple of points in 19-14. And St. Bonaventure's gone a bit cold over the last 2 minutes and 40 seconds. No field goals, and they haven't scored in that time. And the Bonnies have missed their last 6 shots and had only 2 of 9. And Pepperdine on a 7-0 run over the last 2 minutes and 17 seconds. The Waves are doing a great job rebounding. Rebounding the Bonnies 14-6. That was one of the strengths in St. Bonaventure's win against Central Michigan. They dominated on offensive rebounds, scored a lot of points on second and third opportunities, and so the Waves have concentrated on doing a much better job at the defensive end and not giving St. Bonaventure that second and third effort. Meanwhile, Pepperdine has 7 second-chance points on 6 offensive rebounds, so a 14-6 differential. Pepperdine only 4-14 from the floor, 28%. St. Bonaventure, 7-17, 41%. 3-point shooting, the Bonnies 3-7, 43%. Pepperdine 1-2, 50%. But it's the free throws. Pepperdine 5-5. St. Bonaventure 2-2. Waves and Bonnies each scoring 6 in the paint. Pepperdine has been so good scoring in the paint this year, they've outscored their opponents 220-148. When you look at the West Coast Conference and the Atlantic 10, probably the two best mid-major conferences in the country. So when it comes to basketball, but you'd get an argument from the MAC and Missouri Valley Conference USA, amongst others, but the two conferences just outstanding. This is Reyes front court, dribbles in deep, throws it out to Murray in the right wing. His three-pointer's good. Lamont Murray now with 8. His dad, Lamont Sr., played at Cal, 11 years in the NBA. Lamont Murray considered one of the top 20 small forwards in the nation by one publication. The Waves are down by only 2, 19-17. This is Adams up top to Mobley. Ianni in deep to Greg against the zone. In deep to Ianni, lays it up and in. Nice patience by St. Bonaventure, 21-17. The Bonnies lead, but the zone certainly has created some problems for St. Bonaventure. It has gotten Pepperdine back in this game. Reyes left side to Murray. His 22-foot shot rolls in and comes out. And taken by Mobley. Mobley in the front court. Quick guard underneath. Taki lays it up and in. Oh, Taki with the lay-in. And Taki now with 7 points, 23-17, St. Bonaventure. The send right side. Left side to Helms back in the lap. Dribble down the lane in the air, throw it up and in. Knocks Helms out of Tomball, Texas, just outside of Houston. About a 3-hour ride. Houston east of Austin, Texas. South of Dallas, north of San Antonio. Greg up top, 17-foot shot is good. Denzel Greg was 6. He's averaging 12 and 6 rebounds a game. He has struggled at the free throw line this year, just 1 of 5. But a key player for the Bonnies. Right side to Elijah Lee, freshman from Houston. Right side to Murray in the corner. His 3-pointer and got it again. Lamont Murray. The Waves will continue to look to Murray while he's got the hot hands. Murray, the senior out of Los Angeles, considered a top NBA prospect, as is Jalen Adams of St. Bonaventure. 25-22 Bonnies. Taki down low to Greg. One bounce dribble. Back out to Mobley. Dribble in the key underneath. Scoop shot is good. Matt Mobley. He has 8. 27-22. Pepperdine trailing. 8:55 to play. Elijah Lee to Reyes, and we get a foul on Ianni. Second on him, 3 team fouls against St. Bonaventure. As Jonathan Allen comes in, the 6'4 senior from Nashville, Tennessee, a walk-on. Ryan Keenan back in. Pepperdine without the services of Amadi Udini. Remember late last night, he turned an ankle, came back in the game, and hit a key three-pointer. And Udini really a outstanding player for Pepperdine. So the Waves will have to go this game without him, as well as Cameron Edwards, an outstanding 6'6 sophomore forward. Left side major, three-point shot is too long. Mobley has it for St. Bonaventure. Right side to Adams. Waves do a good job. They get back defensively. With these teams, 3 games in 3 days. This is Adams dribbling to the lane in deep, laid up and missed the shot. Rebound trying to save the Waves do, but it goes to Greg, who puts up the shot, no good. They battle for it. Taki grabs it to Adams, major tips, and we're going to get a foul. Going to be on Jeremy Major. One on him. 14 fouls against Pepperdine. St. Bonaventure 27, Pepperdine 22. 8:18 to go. All four teams in this tournament are 1-1. In the second game, Little Rock will take on Central Michigan. It should be an excellent game. Four outstanding mid-major schools. This is Adams to Greg. Waves in the zone, and Nate Gehring back in for Pepperdine. 6'10 redshirt sophomore. Mobley, top of the key, fires up a three that doesn't go. Lassen with the rebound. Lassen front court dribbling, gets into the lane. To Lee, give it to Gehring, he throws it up and in. Nate Gehring on the assist by Elijah Lee. 27-24 Bonnies. 7:45 to go in the first half. This is Jalen Adams. And an NBA prospect to Greg, right side. Dribbling, bad pass, stolen by Lassen. Turnover for the Bonnies. Lassen in the lane, fumbles that, gets it back and lays it in. Greg Lassen with the putback. 27-26, Bonnies, 7:22 to go. Right side, Mobley, and he gets called for traveling. Get a timeout. 7:18 to play in the first half. Quite a game, quite a tempo. St. Bonaventure 27, Pepperdine 26. Pepperdine has made 4 of their last 5 field goals. And Pepperdine now 9 of 21, 43% from the field. St. Bonaventure 11 of 24, 46% from the floor. But the Bonnies. And one reason when they jumped out to that nice lead, they hadn't turned the ball over. And they just committed back-to-back turnovers. That's just the only two they have committed. And here we have 7:18 to play. Pepperdine's done a nice job. They have 4 turnovers here in the first half. Lamont Murray with 11, leading Pepperdine. And certainly with the hot hand, Pepperdine's going to go to him more and more. He comes in averaging 24 points a game, 5 rebounds a contest. He has made 50% of his threes, 8 of 16 coming in. And Murray today is 3 of 4 behind the arc. And he's shooting 53% overall. Lamont Murray, one of the top players in the nation, a second team all-conference selection last year. And Pepperdine comes in with that 4-1 record against St. Bonaventure at 2-2. Points in the paint, each team with 12. Points off turnovers. St. Bonaventure opportunistic to have 7, as the Waves have turned it over only 4 times. Pepperdine with 2. Waves out rebounding St. Bonaventure 15-10. Top score for St. Bonaventure, 8 for Matt Mobley, and Idris Taki has 7, and 6 for Denzel Gray. 27-26 in favor of St. Bonaventure. Mark Schmidt is the head coach of St. Bonnie in his 10th year. He was the Atlantic 10 Coach of the Year last season. Former head coach at Robert Morris for 6 years. Also an assistant at Xavier, Penn State, and Loyola, Maryland. He played basketball at Boston College, graduating back in 1985. Mark Schmidt at the Bonnies, up and running. Lee dribbled down the lane, left-handed shot, bounces off. Allen jumps up and gets the rebound. It goes to Major. Major right side dribbling against Taki, and we're going to get a foul on Idris Taki. First one on him, 14 foul against the Bonnies. Bonnies 27, Waves 26, 6:58 to go. First half action at halftime. We'll visit with Pepperdine head coach Marty Wilson, interview we taped earlier today. We'll complete rundown of the first half stats, and we'll get you ready for the second half. Murray comes in, Elijah Lee checks out. Waves recruit well in the state of Texas. They have a number of players on their roster. Nolan Taylor, another player, not able to play with sore knees, due back in about a week. You got Lee and Helms also from the Houston area. 15 on the shot clock, 6:41 on the game clock. This is Major left side, dribble, stop in the air. Bank shot is good. Jeremy Major off the dribble, and the Waves lead 28-27. Quite a comeback for Pepperdine. Right side to Adams. It's been the zone that has been the difference for the Waves. This is Adams backing it up. Inside to Taki. Left side, the short jumper, good by David Ando. Just in, a 6'7 senior from Montreal, Quebec. Ando knocking down the jumper. He's another transfer from Liberty College. He redshirted last year, actually started at San Jose State, where he played as a freshman. Ando gives the Bonnies a big lift again. 3 games in 3 days. The NBA doesn't have this type of schedule. Here's Murray bumped, and we should get a foul against the Bonnies. They're going to call it against St. Bonaventure. Team foul number 5. Let's see if he was shooting.
Smart move, Al. Good job, Jay.
At the line, Lamont Murray. Amadi Ekpeze comes in. 6'10 freshman from Buffalo, New York. Chris Reyes in for Craig Lassen, who played well. 29-28. Same Bonaventure as Murray at the line. Waves making their free throws. 5:49 to go. The free throw. Both good. Now 13 for Lamont Murray. We're even at 29. As we get a whistle and a foul away from the ball. It'll be against the Waves. Jonathan Allen, one on him. 5 team fouls against Pepperdine. Out of bounds to St. Bonaventure. Well, both teams are going to have to use their benches liberally. It's just so tough to play 3 games in 3 days. Left side, Taki. Back to Matt Mobley. What a find he has been for the Bonnies. Comes to Ando. 19 on the shot clock. Ando left side, guarded by Reyes in the zone. This is Adams. Adams been somewhat quiet. Taki out in front. His three-pointer is good. Andres Taki now with 10. He averages 7.5 points and 7.5 rebounds a game. 6'4", 200-pound junior from Snellville, Georgia, on the team last year. Haven't been shooting that well, only 35%. Right side, it goes to Reyes, 32-29 Bonnies, 5 minutes to go. This is Jeremy Major. Bonnies have been a straight man-to-man defense. Major top of the key, three-pointer is good. Jeremy Major was 7, and we're even at 32. In the front court, Ando to Mobley. Out to Adams. Taki back to Adams, dribbling. Mobley, dribble left side along the baseline. Taki, his short jumper doesn't go. We get a foul. It'll be on Ekpeze just into the game. 6'10", 250.
Go!
17 fouls against the Bonnies, and the Waves will go down at the other end and will shoot 1-1. Biggest lead of the game early. St. Bonaventure by 12. And they did a great job knocking down their shots early and not turning the ball over. 4:34 to go in the first half, and Nate Gehring at the line. Free throw is up and rolls off the front end of a 1-1, and the rebound grabbed by Denzel Gregg as Jalen Adams comes in the front court. This is Mobley swinging left side to Taki. Waves seemingly giving him the open look. He hasn't shot well this season until tonight. Down the lane, Mobley throws it up and in from 12 feet. Matt Mobley with 10. Taki with also has 10, 34-32, St. Bonaventure. from upstate New York, just south of Buffalo, about 60 miles. Down the lane, Murray's in deep, scoop shot knocked away by Greg. But there is a foul. It'll be against the Bonnies. It'll be on Taki. Second on him. 18 fouls against the Bonnies. An entertaining first half, 3:58 to go. And St. Bonaventure with a 34-32 lead. Are you listening to Wavescast? And Pepperdine would like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of Pepperdine men's basketball. And make sure you subscribe to the new podcast, Pep Talk, which features interviews with the coaches, student athletes, administrators, and alums that make Pepperdine so great. You can find it on iTunes or other podcasting apps. And make sure you follow at Pep Basketball on Twitter, Pepperdine Hoops on Instagram, and Pepperdine Men's Basketball on Facebook for all the latest news and information on the team. And update your bookmarks as the official website is now located at PepperdineWaves.com. News, schedule, scores, stats, and more can be found on the official athletics website. Pepperdine, they will head home tomorrow morning very early, have a 6 a.m. flight. Should be back in Southern California about 7 a.m. And then get ready for Portland State on Sunday. We'll have a live digital TV Wavescast at 2:30. The Vikings and Pepperdine. It's part of a doubleheader. Pepperdine women will take on Duke at noon, and that game also will be live on Wavescast. And so we hope everybody has a great Thanksgiving. A lot to be thankful for, so we don't take anything for granted. As this year quickly winding down in the holiday season upon us. A beautiful day here in Austin. We are in Cedar Park, about 15 miles north of Austin, Texas. All the teams are staying in Austin. Population of Cedar Park is about 70,000. Capacity here at the HEB Center is around 6,000. Not a bad crowd. I'd say well above 500. HEB, by the way, is a grocery market chain here in the Southwest. Kind of like Ralph's in Southern California. First ever meeting between the two schools. A championship on the line. All four teams are 1-1. And for St. Bonaventure, their next game Wednesday, November 30th, they will host Siena. Marty Wilson, the head coach of Pepperdine in his sixth season, 21 years in assistant coach, 9 with Pepperdine, also assistants at San Diego, Santa Barbara, and Utah, played for the Waves in the mid to late 1980s as the free throw missing by Murray. And the Waves have been in the CBI tournament the last 2 years. Murray for one more. 76% last year. This one is good. He has 14. Murray this year at 75% at the charity stripe. It's a one-point game. St. Bonaventure with the lead in the ball. Adams throws up a long three at the top of the key. Is good. Jalen Adams from out in front. Had to be at least 23 feet out, way above the NBA line. Left side to Murray, 37-33. Adams with five. Murray left side. His three-point shot's no good, but a foul. Going to be on Greg. Greg's first. 19 fouls against the Bunnies, and Lamont Murray's going to get three free throws. 37-33, St. Bonaventure. Murray held only 9 points last night. Number five scorer in the nation. As they will mop things up. Lamont Murray, having just an outstanding start to this season, the senior. So Murray's free throw, the first one, up and good already with 15 first half points. So the Waves down 37-34. Next one is good as Lassen comes in. And Nate Gehring comes out. Pepperdine with Helms, Lee, Reyes, along with Lassen and Murray. Waves without Amadi Udini, Cameron Edwards, Kaijay Yee Stevens also out of the lineup with a sore foot. In three games in 3 days, you need bodies. Murray makes all three. He has 16. The Waves down by one, 37-36. Adams left side. And in the corner to Mobley, dribbles, gets called for traveling. That is just the third turnover for St. Bonaventure. Pepperdine with only four. It has been a well-played game. We have 3:20 to go in the first half. Waves are moving left to right in their blue, white, and orange. Elijah Lee in, has a lot of family and friends here on this Wednesday, a day before Thanksgiving. Waves go back to work on Friday. They don't have much time off. Seven on the shot clock. Lee left side tries to take it up. Adams got a piece of it and then taken by Griffin. And the Bonnies control. Bonnie's led by as much as 12 in the first half. Adams right side is long. Three-pointer good again. Shaylen Adams. The two players the Waves need to shut down on the perimeter are Adams and Mobley. And they've been knocking down threes. Mobley in the game with 10. Adams now with 8. He's hit back-to-back threes. 40-36 St. Bonaventure. Lee dribbling top of the key. 2:24 to go. Lee and Helms over to Murray. 6 on the shot clock. Murray in along the baseline. 19-foot jumper short. Gray gets it for St. Bonaventure. Midcourt to Mobley. Mobley right side to Adams. The Waves need to pressure that outside. Here's Mobley's three-pointer from the top of the key. Doesn't go. Lassen gets it for Pepperdine. Down the floor to Murray on the baseline. He'll get called for traveling.
Hey, get it to your point guard.
Five turnovers for the Waves. That's all. In this tournament, in the first two games, they had committed 35. They've done a much better job of taking care of the ball, but they've been called three times for traveling. And the officials have been given unnoticed to call that traveling violation, as well as the hand checking. You know, the officials usually do that at the start of a season. Once they get into conference, they let things go and let the teams play. 1:44 left in the first half. Inside Ando along the baseline. Short jumper is good. Ando off the bench with 4. He played his high school basketball in Berkeley, California. He transferred from Liberty. 42-36 Bonnies. 1:25 left. Elijah Lee dribble on the baseline. Give it to Lassen in the lane, who throws it up and in. Nice pass by Lee. Lassen has 6. 42-38 Bonnies. This is Griffin, left side, out to Greg. Waves stay in that zone. Ando's pass is tipped, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by St. Bonaventure. They turn it over, they're 4. The thing with the zone, and the Waves have been in it for about 15 minutes as Pepperdine takes a timeout. The Waves are down by 4, 42-38. 1 minute and 5 seconds remaining. But when you stay in the zone that long, teams will adjust. So see if Marty Wilson makes some changes to begin the second half of this game. Have to stay in that zone throughout. Might go to a 1-2-2 and vary that 2-3. The teams just instinctively will adjust and start finding the open spots and making shots. The second annual Lone Star Showcase in Cedar Park, Texas, just north of Austin, about 15 miles. This is the first men's showcase, however. Last year, this tournament had 8 women's teams. Waves home on Sunday, November 27th against Portland State. Tip-off at 2:30. We'll have a live Waves cast. You'll be able to watch and listen. Now Pepperdine with the ball going left to right, 42-38. Waves were down by as much as 12 and battled back. Lee left side to Murray. Boy, it's that East Coast, West Coast battle. Styles the play. Reyes backs in. Underneath the Lassen lays it up and in. Lassen moving well without the ball. Reyes is an excellent passer and found the open man. 42 seconds left. 42-40. Pepperdine down by 2. And we get a timeout taken by St. Bonaventure. There was a time that, and it's a while ago, that the Atlantic 10 and West Coast Conference wanted to have kind of a challenge series. You know, like the Big Ten and the ACC, it never materialized, but it could be a pretty good idea to take the top teams, all the teams would battle. A nice showcase for both conferences. Of course, Gonzaga ranked number 14, St. Mary's number 17. Atlantic 10, Dayton is picked to win the conference this year. Well, St. Mary's went back to Dayton only a couple days ago, and they knocked off the Flyers. St. Mary's rated number 17. West Coast Conference is off to a great start. They have five unbeaten teams, and overall are 28-10. Right, Mobley to throw it in. As the shot clock about 13 seconds ahead of the game clock. This is Adams. Adams dribbling, waves in that 2-3 zone. LeSam Reyes and Murray along the baseline. Left side, Greg is long shot missing. It goes Diane. Shot blocked from behind by Murray. 16 seconds. Waves can tie, maybe take the lead. This is Major dribbling the front court. Down to 8 seconds. Major near midcourt against Adams with 5. Major inside dribbling the ball. Knocked away with 2. Major puts it up. Shot no good. And time runs out. And the first half is over. Major had a battle inside. I'm surprised there wasn't a foul called. But the first half comes to an end. And St. Bonaventure with a 42-40 lead over Pepperdine in this final day of the Lone Star Showcase. A championship at stake. All four teams are 1-1. The Waves led in the first half by Lamont Murray with 16. And for St. Bonaventure, made a lot of threes in that first half. 6 of 13, an outstanding 46%. They came into the game, would you believe, 31% beyond the arc, but not tonight. Idris Taki had 10, Jalen Adams with 8, and 10 for Matt Mobley, as the Bonnies led most of the way in this game. Of the Atlantic 10 Conference, there are 14 schools, and for St. Bonaventure to be pick number 5 is pretty good. You've got St. Bonaventure, Dayton, as we mentioned, picked to win the league, Virginia Commonwealth, Rhode Island, Duquesne, George Mason, LaSalle, Davidson, St. Louis, Richmond, George Washington, Fordham, Massachusetts, and St. Joseph. So it's an outstanding mid-major conference, really one of the best. But the West Coast Conference and Atlantic 10 in a real battle as the Bonnies with a 42-40 lead at the break. Glad you could be with us on this Wednesday, a day before Thanksgiving. I'm Al Epstein on this Wednesday evening, a beautiful day in Austin. While you're listening to Wavescast, and Pepperdine Athletics would like to extend its thanks to the following businesses for their support this season: The Parking Spot, Coca-Cola, Gold Coast Tours, Dukes of Malibu, the Warner Center Marriott, the Enzi Calabasas Hotel, Chick-fil-A, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, National Car Rental, Primetime Shuttle, and Wells Fargo. And Pepperdine would like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of Pepperdine men's basketball. 3 ties, 2 lead changes in this one. Pepperdine's biggest lead just 1 late here in the first half, but the Waves battled back from a 12-point deficit at the 14:40 mark and finally settled down and started making some shots and able to get back in the game. The Waves end up shooting only 43%, 13 of 30, but 4-7 on threes, 57%. For St. Bonaventure, 17 of 35 from the floor, 49%, and 6 of 13 on threes, 46%. Rebounding, the Waves have done a nice job. Have the edge, 21-14, 9 on the offensive glass that have led to 9 points. The Bonnies have 5 rebounds, only 3 turnovers. Pepperdine with 5. It has been a very well-played game so far. That traveling violation has popped up now and then, but overall, both teams going at it. You would think they might be a little bit tired, but that doesn't seem to be the case with a pretty high-scoring first half of play, and the St. Bonaventure with a 42-40 advantage. Top scorer for Pepperdine, Lamont Murray, was 16 on 4 of 10 shooting, but he's made 3 of 4 on threes. St. Bonaventure, Idris Taki had 10 points, Matt Mobley with 10, Jalen Adams had 8. Halftime score, Pepperdine trailing St. Bonaventure 42-40. Earlier today, had a chance to visit with Pepperdine Head basketball coach Marty Wilson. So let's go to that interview right now.
Well, Coach, welcome back to day number three of the Lone Star Showcase. Waves coming up a terrific win last night. Talk a little bit about that contest against a very good Little Rock team, but better be proud of your basketball team for bouncing back after a loss a couple days earlier. But tremendous effort, and they really competed.
Very proud of our team. There's certain guys that stood out. I thought Jeremy was outstanding. He was aggressive. I mentioned to him, he had a little cockiness to him, basically showing the other team that you can't stay in front of me. And he got by guys. He made the right plays. I mean, he made a great play out of a timeout where he refused a screen going in for that left-hand layup. I mean, that was a huge play. But that's something that we need to see more, his speed. We want people to fear his speed. And now they back off, and now he can get those open jump shots. I thought Lamont did a great job. Although he didn't score well, didn't shoot it well, I thought late game he defended and he made a couple of nice key passes to his teammates. I mean, we talk about that. What else are you guys going to do when you're not scoring, when your shot's not falling? And he did those things.
And it shows your basketball team has other players that can step up if Lamont does have an off night. And that's certainly a key, so teams really cannot key on Lamont.
Well, and that's something that we want to have because we're going to have those days. Jeremy had won his first game. He didn't shoot the ball, didn't score the ball very well, but he had 11 assists and zero turnovers. So we need guys to actually be multi-dimensional players. And I think we have those guys. I think we have a very unselfish team. I mean, we had a couple of passing plays where ball went in to Chris to Craig, and I mean layup, and then vice versa. So guys are starting to see that. We want to show them more and more that that's how we have to play, because we have multiple guys who can do multiple things. And the better we play like that, the more we play like that, the tougher it's going to be for people to guard us at times.
The development of Brian Kenyon and Nate Guerin is so vital to this year's success. Certainly Nate Guerin stepped up a little bit. Brian Kenyon's been starting. He's done his job, but those two players are very important, and Nate Guerin came in and did a nice job overall off the bench.
Yeah, the biggest thing for Ryan are the matchups, who he's guarding. Are they able to take him out on the perimeter? Can we switch certain situations? So that's the biggest challenge for him. With Nate, he's athletic enough to switch out and guard some perimeter guys when he's focused and dialed in, and he's done a great job. The thing that we tell Nate, he's got to be athletic and alert. And when he's that, he's a really good player at both ends of the floor.
Game number three, the NBA doesn't play this tough on their schedule. As you approach this game, how do you look at your bench once again? Amadi Udine is another one, of course, and he's going to be okay to play tonight.
Well, Amadi, yeah, he's probably one of the toughest guys I've been around. And tell you what, he surprised me when he was out. He come limping out. He's off to the side. I didn't see him until we turned the ball over, and he just popped up, says, "Coach, I'm ready." And I was glad he was ready. So he will go. He'll be fine. We have to watch him early, but I have to go deep in the bench. You will see John Allen play some, mainly because he can defend, he's tough, and he can rebound. And we didn't rebound very well yesterday, so we have to do a better job of that. And we have to have some other guys get down there and rebound and help our big guys out when they're blocking out.
When you watch St. Bonaventure from New York, obviously coming up in California, styles of play, is it that much different, or basketball is basketball?
The styles are different. They're probably going to try to be more aggressive. We talked about that. They want to attack. They want to drive. They want to see what they saw last night, what the other teams are trying to do, and trying to pick up fouls. But we have to be smarter. They have two really good guards that we have to contain on the inside off of the penetration and on the outside with their jump shots. But we can shrink off the other guys and plug gaps. So we have to make sure we stay dialed in. I know our veteran guys will. our young guys will still get excited and want to run out and close out to their guys. But we said we got to show numbers. They got to see our eyes looking at them on the play. So I think the style is going to be totally different, but we have to match their toughness.
And so we're taking care of the basketball in this game. St. Bonaventure forces almost 18 turnovers a game, and that'll be very, very important.
Well, the disappointing thing for us, teams that they've been pressing us, but we haven't turned the ball over in the press. So we've had a lot of unforced turnovers, travels, or bullet passes, things like that shouldn't create a turnover, especially with our veteran guys. And when we don't turn the ball over, we're shooting over 50% in most of our games. So we have to value the ball a little bit more in crucial situations.
Coach, we appreciate the visit. Sir, the best of luck in this third day in this Lone Star Showcase deep in the Southwest. Thanks again, and let's hit the ropes and get themselves a win and make that trip home a little bit nicer.
All right, thanks. I appreciate it.
Welcome back to the HEB Center in Cedar Park, Texas. It is halftime. And head coach Marty Wilson of the Waves, our guest, I'm Al Epstein, and the Waves down by a couple at 42-40 to St. Bonaventure out of only New York, population around 10,000. It is a small school, actually about 1,600 students. Pepperdine, rather small school, private school, with around 7,500. And quite a game so far, and the first half stats have come out. Just a reminder, you are listening to Wavescast, and Pepperdine Athletics would like to extend its thanks to the following businesses for their support this season. The Parking Spot, Coca-Cola, Gold Coast Tours, Dukes of Malibu, the Warner Center Marriott, the Enzi Calabasas Hotel, Chick-fil-A, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, National Car Rental, Primetime Shuttle, and Wells Fargo. And Pepperdine would like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of Pepperdine men's basketball. And make sure you subscribe to the new podcast, Pep Talk, which features interviews with the coaches, student athletes, administrators, and alums that make Pepperdine so great. You can find it on iTunes or other podcasting apps. First half stats, the St. Bonaventure, 17 of 35 from the field, a very good 49%. They came into the game shooting 47% this season. Pepperdine, 13 of 30, 43%. They have been shooting much better than that, just under 50%, 49% plus. And the Waves making 4 of 7 threes, 57%. St. Bonaventure, 6 of 13 beyond the arc, a strong 46%. At the free throw line, Pepperdine, fortunately, making their free throws. They have outscored St. Bonaventure at the line 10-2, making 10 of 13. St. Bonaventure has gone to the line only twice and made both. Rebounding, Pepperdine 21, 9 on the offensive glass. That has led to 9 points. St. Bonaventure with 14, 5 on the offensive boards. Turnovers, Pepperdine with only 5 and St. Bonaventure with 3. Both teams came into this game averaging 14 turnovers a contest. We'll see if both teams get a bit tired in the second half. Third game in 3 days. As we mentioned, the NBA doesn't make their players go to this tough a schedule. Now we'll find out, as both coaches will certainly use their bench quite a bit as this game moves on. St. Bonaventure back on the court. Individual scoring, and we mentioned that the Waves trailed by as many as 12. And their biggest lead was only 1. For Pepperdine, Jeremy Major had 7 points on 2 of 7 shooting. He did have 3 rebounds and 1 assist. That moves him into sole possession all-time at Pepperdine with 396 assists, now passing Doug Christie. He is chasing the all-time mark of Mark Wilson, who played at Pepperdine from 1981 through 84. He had 450 assists. So Jeremy Major needing 55 to become the all-time assist leader. Chris Reyes with 3 points. We'll see if the Waves look for him a little bit more in this second half. Reyes He was averaging 16 points, almost 9 rebounds a game while shooting 72% from the field. Only gets a couple of shots. I think St. Bonaventure really trying to stop Reyes inside, which can open things up on the perimeter for Pepperdine. Knox Helm starting in place of the Waves, a point guard. Amadi Udini, such a big loss. Udini's been playing so well, averaging 8 points and over 6 assists per game. Also at 13 threes, shooting better than 40% beyond the arc. That turned ankle late last night in the win against Little Rock. He did come back in the game, was instrumental in Pepperdine winning that game 66-65. But Udini gave it a go. Had a lot of ice on his ankle all day late last night, but just couldn't do it. And the Waves also without Cameron Edwards, their outstanding 6'6 forward. Kaije Yee Stevens, a promising freshman guard, he's out with a sore foot. And Nolan Taylor out of Keller, Texas, big 6'7, 250-pound forward. He's out with sore knees. He's expected back in a week. Hopefully Udini will return maybe by Sunday against Portland State. The Waves then get about a week off before they take on Belmont. Lamont Murray was the star in the first half for Pepperdine, 16 points and 3 rebounds. He made 3 of 4 threes, 5 of 7 at the line, and 4 of 10 shooting. Ryan Keenan did not score. Elijah Lee was scoreless but did have 4 assists. Nate Gehring with 4. Jonathan Allen did not score. And Craig Lassen, 8 points and 3 rebounds in 13 minutes of play. Pepperdine back on the court. We get ready for the second half. St. Bonaventure. Idris Taki had 10 points. Matt Mobley with 10. Jalen Adams with 8 on 2 of 7 shooting. Mobley was 4 of 9, but they were combined 4 of 10 on threes. Denzel Gregg, 6 points and 6 rebounds. Josh Ieni had 4. David Ando with 4. Janonzo Obiko did not score. Ladarian Griffin was scoreless. And Amadi Ikpezi was scoreless as well. 42-40, St. Bonaventure over Pepperdine. Both teams 1-1 in this tournament. The second game, it should be another outstanding contest, Little Rock and Central Michigan. For St. Bonaventure, they'll play again on Wednesday, November the 30th. They're home against Siena. Our officials for today's game, all from the Big 12, Kevin Mathis, Jeff Malham, and Kirby Sitton. Pepperdine 4-1 on the season, coached by Marty Wilson in his sixth year. Assisted by Mark Amaral, the associate head coach. John Impleman and Brian Moore are the assistants. St. Bonaventure at 2-2. They're headed by Mark Schmidt in his 10th year. 148 wins, 134 losses. But last season, the Atlantic 10 coach of the year. Did a great job winning the A-10 or tying for the championship. Pepperdine comes back out with Reyes, Gehring starting the second half in place of Keenan, Major, Helms, and Murray. For St. Bonaventure, Adams, Mobley, Taki, Ieni, and Greg. And it will be St. Bonaventure moving left to right to begin the second half in their white and brown. Pepperdine stays in their zone at 2-3. This is Murray and Major up top. High post to Greg, 14 on the shot clock. One bounce dribble, Adams, 17-foot jumper goes in and comes out. The rebound is off, we're gonna get a foul. It'll be against St. Bonaventure. Josh Ieni, 3 on him. First team foul in the second half against St. Bonaventure. Ieni probably gonna have to come out. Talented 6'8", 215-pound freshman from Nigeria, played high school ball in Maryland at St. Francis Academy. Came in averaging 7 points a game. High screen by Gehring, Major top of the key. Left side to Murray, dribble drive to the baseline. Stop in the air, throw up the shot, no good, but it's fouled. It's gonna be on Taki. Taki's, that's his third. Second team foul against the Bonnies, and Lamont Murray will be at the line. Murray, the number 5 scorer in the nation. He dropped a little bit with only 9 points yesterday. He's having a big game this evening. He's averaging just under 24. Makes the first, now with 17. That's the start of the second half, 19-14 to go. Next one rolls in. 18 for Murray. I think Pepperdine's got to get Reyes involved in the offense as well as Jeremy Major. And Murray can carry a team and can take over a contest. He's that talented. Well, we're tied at 42. And St. Bonaventure in the front court. Greg left side to Mobley. Right side to Adams along the baseline by Enny. In the lane it goes to Griffin. Pass tipped and taken by Reyes. Pepperdine forces the turnover. Only the fourth for St. Bonaventure. Right side Major. Major being guarded by Mobley. The Bonnies doing a little bit more double teaming in their man-to-man. Outside Murray, a long shot from 20 feet doesn't go. And Mobley has it for St. Bonaventure. Adams way out in front. Swinging left side to Greg. Dribble drive into the basket. Throw it up and it goes in and comes out. Gehring stood his ground. The Waves have it. Major in the front court will stop and shoot a three-pointer that hits the rim. Long bounce. Greg to Adams. Adams in the front court. Greg in the lane. Pass is kicked. And the ball will go to St. Bonaventure. Well, David Ando, 6'7", senior from Montreal, Quebec, who actually played basketball in Northern California, started his career at San Jose State. Ball comes into Mobley as three-pointer is good. Mobley at the top of the key, knocking down the three, and Mobley in the game now at 13. Waves must contain that perimeter, Mobley and Adams, if they're going to win this contest. That's the two shooters. For St. Bonaventure, left side to Major, 45-42. Bonnies, 17-49 to play. Major down the lane, dribbling. We're going to get, they call trembling on Jeremy Major. Would you believe? Six turnovers for the Waves. Chinonzo Obiko, 6'9", senior from Nigeria. He's a redshirt. He transferred from Syracuse. He was a reserve. With the Orangemen, this gives the Bonnies a little more presence inside and some size. And now we're going to get a whistle, a foul away from the ball. It's against Ando, a legal screen. First on him, three team fouls against St. Bonaventure, and Pepperdine will have it. And moving right to left in the blue, orange, and white. And St. Bonaventure in their white and brown. Reyes left side, posting up, backs in, pivots, right-handed shot rejected by Obiko. Nice play by the senior from Nigeria, 6'9". Right side to Adams, a screen by Obiko. And we'll kick it back to Mobley, 17-14 to go in the second half. Left side, Greg, one bounce dribble stop, 15-foot shot rolls off, and Helms with the rebound for Pepperdine. 45-42 Bonnies, front court. Pepperdine with the ball. This is Major, top of the key. Get a screen by Reyes. Go to the left side. Back to Reyes, to Major. Dribble down the lane. Held down the dribble. Going to be on Jalen Adams. Second on him. Four team fouls against St. Bonaventure. They're slowly but surely getting into foul trouble. 16:51 to go. Pepperdine with no team fouls in the second half. Major underneath. Bonnie's basket comes into Gehring. And back out to Murray in the left wing, guarded by Greg. Murray get a screen by Gehring. Backs it up to Major. Right side, Helms on the baseline to Reyes. And the Waves will utilize some clock. Major right side, dribble along the baseline to Reyes. 17 footers, good. Chris Reyes on the baseline. Major with the assist, and Reyes with seven. 45-44, Bonnies with the lead and the ball. Now, Jim Van Bredekoff coached at St. Bonaventure for a couple of years. Before he took the job, he was at Pepperdine for two seasons. One of the best X and O coaches around. Got a little bit of trouble and then left the program, and driving is Adams and lays it up and in. Adams with 10. VBK as good an X and O coach as you ever wanted to see. 2 years at Pepperdine, did a great job. Down to the NCAA tournament. Knocked off Indiana in an opening round game. Left in Buffalo, New York, of all places. Along the baseline, Gehring back to Murray. 17-foot jumper is short. And the rebound grabbed by Ando. In the front court, Mobley is going to stop and shoot a three-pointer and got it. Matt Mobley now with 16. 50-44. Bonnies with the lead at 15-19 to go. As Jeremy Major comes in the front court. I'm a little surprised that neither coach has utilized their timeouts with three games in 3 days just to give players a bit of a respite. And with St. Bonaventure on a run, as Reyes pass to Major, deep in the corner, Helms, a big three-pointer is good. Max Helms, assist to Jeremy Major, Helms with five. Much-needed basket for Pepperdine, they're down 50-47. Outside, Adams fires up a three and knocks it down. From 23 feet out, Jalen Adams. Adams with 13, Mobley with 16. They combined to average 42.5 points a game early in the season. Of the 81, St. Bonaventure averages. Daring left side to Reyes, 53-47 Bonnies. Reyes inside, pivots, tries to take it up, and draws the foul. Let me on Obico. For Obico, that is his first. Already five team fouls against St. Bonaventure. Pepperdine with none. Your head coach Mark Schmidt, you're going to let the officials know that. Hey, look at the scoreboard, 5-0 in fouls. Are you listening to Wavescast? And Pepperdine Athletics would like to extend its thanks to the following businesses for their support this season. The Parking Spot, Coca-Cola, Gold Coast Tours, Dukes of Malibu, the Warner Center Marriott, the Enza Calabasas Hotel, Chick-fil-A, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, National Car Rental, Primetime Shuttle, and Wells Fargo. And Pepperdine would like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of Pepperdine men's basketball. And make sure you follow at Pep Basketball on Twitter, Pepperdine Hoops on Instagram, and Pepperdine Men's Basketball on Facebook for all the latest news and information on the team. Glad you could be with us on this Wednesday, Thanksgiving tomorrow. Certainly have a great day and enjoy a lot to be thankful for, the holiday season upon us. Beautiful day here in Austin, about 70 degrees, lots of sunshine, blue skies. As the Waves head home early tomorrow morning and have a 6 a.m. flight. They won't get much sleep tonight, but they'll enjoy Thanksgiving with family and friends and back to practice on Friday and get ready for Portland State on Sunday the 27th, a 2:30 p.m. game. We'll have a live Waves cast. You'll be able to watch it on digital TV. Part of a doubleheader, the Pepperdine women will take on Duke at noon. And you'll be able to watch that as well. Pepperdine women earlier today was at New Mexico State. And they battled hard, but they came up short 75-66. And the Pepperdine women's volleyball team, quite a win last night. They knock off number 11, San Diego, 3-1 to deny San Diego a West Coast Conference championship. Brigham Young slips in for the title. Second half, St. Bonaventure 4-7 from the field. More impressively, 3-3 on threes. They are 9-16 on three-pointers, 56% beyond the arc. Pepperdine second half, 2-6 from the field, 33%. They are 5-10 on threes, 50%, which is excellent. Rebounding, 23-18 Waves. Pepperdine with 6 turnovers. St. Bonaventure with 5. Reyes at the line makes the free throw. He has 8. Reyes, 2-2 at the line. Free throw rolls in and out. The rebound comes off, and they're going to call a foul. They're going to call on Jonathan Allen of Pepperdine. Marty Wilson off the bench thought it was on St. Bonaventure. So Allen, number 2 on him. First team foul in the second half again. The differential, 5-1. St. Bonaventure getting into foul trouble. This is Adams top of the key. Elijah Lee in for Pepperdine. Waves in the 2-3. Mary Allen and Reyes down low. Lee and Major up top. Waves thin on bodies. Mobley left side. Fires a 22-footer. No good. Mobley with the rebound. Lays it up. Shot partially blocked in a foul. Going to be on Chris Reyes. Number 2 on him. And the second team foul in the second half. 13:56 to go. 53-48, St. Bonaventure. And Mobley at the line. Excellent free throw shooter, 83%, and he knocks that one down. Mobley in the game was 17. His career best is 28. Actually, he tied it last night in that win over Central Michigan. Free throw, that is good. He has 18, and St. Bonaventure by 7, 55-48. A lot of time to go, Major in the front court. Comes to Elijah Lee. As the Bonnies setting up a bit of a zone, a 3-2, interesting. Slow Pepperdine down inside. Ray is roaming the baseline. Major on the left wing, his three-pointer is off the mark from 21 feet away. Rebound grabbed by Endo. Long pass ahead to Mobley, and he's hit him foul. It'll be on Jonathan Allen. Three on Allen, 13 foul against the Waves. Craig Lassen and Lamont Murray will come out. That zone set up by St. Bonaventure. Adams to trigger it in under the Waves basket. In deep to Ando, pushes his way in, throws it up and in. It counts his foul. Foul's going to be on Lassen. Lassen's first, 14 fouls against Pepperdine. Well, they picked up the four fouls in about a minute. And Ando at the line has given St. Bonaventure a big lift. He has 6 points, make it 7. Biggest deficit in the second half of the Waves, 10, 58, 48. They trailed by 12 in the first half. Major against that 3-2. It's a different look for St. Bonaventure. Lee right side dribbling against Adams. Lee top of the key. Underneath the Reyes, one bounce dribble, a shot rejected inside by Obico. Taken by St. Bonaventure. This is Mobley, swing it out to Adams, 23 footer for three is good. Timeout Pepperdine. St. Bonaventure knocking down threes. Biggest lead of the game, 13, 61-48, Bonnies, 12:55 to go. But with a high-scoring game like this is, it will allow Pepperdine to get back in this contest because the ball goes up very quickly for St. Bonaventure. But the Bonnies continue to knock down threes. Kind of reminds us of the other night against Central Michigan. They're 10 of 18, 56% beyond the arc. And the second half, 4-5. Keep in mind, St. Bonaventure came into this game making only 31% of their three-pointers. Waves shot well beyond the arc, 5 of 11, almost 46%. But overall, shooting a bit under 40%, 15 of 38. St. Bonaventure, 23 of 45 from the floor, an excellent 51%. They've got Mobley with 18, Adams with 13. Again, they're the 1-2 punch for St. Bonaventure. As we mentioned, they average between them 42.5 points a game, a little more than half what St. Bonaventure as a team averages, which is 81. Pepperdine led by Lamont Murray with 18. But with the Waves bench so thin, you might see some of the Waves players get a bit tired. Hopefully not. They've got Murray out of the lineup right now. Has 18 points on 4 of 12 shooting. Chris Reyes, just 6 points. Well, Pepperdine's got to find somebody else to get on the board. Jeremy Major was 7, but without Amadi Udini, Cameron Edwards, Kajay Yee Stevens, and Nolan Taylor, that's 4 key players Pepperdine does not have available. And Udini's a starting point guard. Edwards is starting forward. Waves are using a lot of freshmen. Well, it does take its toll. And Pepperdine, head coach Marty Wilson, trying to manage his players in and out of the lineup, get them some rest when they can. Give a lot of credit to St. Bonaventure. They played well in making their threes. Pepperdine ball in the backcourt. They're moving right to left, and the Bonnies up by 13. Pressure Lee with Adams. Elijah Lee is an excellent ball handler. Very, very quick at 5'10". Lee right side. And swing it to Major. Major in the corner to Murray. Murray with the back up the dribble. Major top of the key. Against the zone. Right side Lee fires up a three that doesn't go. Rebound LeSan is good. Greg LeSan with 10. Outstanding 6'9 freshman. He played his high school basketball in Maryland. Originally from Sweden, where he played for Sweden's junior national program. Left side to Greg. Much needed basket for Pepperdine. 61-50. Waves down by 11. They're in that zone again. The Waves have been in the zone most of the game. Greg, short jumper, hits the rim. Rebound inside is Obico, but he can't make it. Pepperdine has it. Major in the front court, left side. Bonnies get back in transition. In deep to LeSan, left alone. Puts up the shot, rejected by Obico. Shinonzo Obico, a transfer from Syracuse, where he was a reserve. Redshirted last season. As we get a timeout, 11:46 to play in the second half. St. Bonaventure 61, Pepperdine 50. You're listening to Wavescast, and Pepperdine would like to extend its thanks to Nike, the official outfitter of Pepperdine men's basketball. And make sure you subscribe to the new podcast Pep Talk, which features interviews with the coaches, student athletes, administrators, and alums that make Pepperdine so great. You can find it on iTunes or other podcasting apps. Third day of the tournament, game number two, Little Rock and Central Michigan. It should be another excellent game. But those teams 1-1. The way is Marty Wilson to our right. A couple other games involving the West Coast Conference tonight. San Francisco home against Troy, and Gonzaga, ranked number 14, home against Quinnipiac. And Brigham Young playing Valparaiso in Las Vegas tonight. BYU, another unbeaten team, as is San Francisco and Gonzaga. And you throw in St. Mary's as well, and you have a very strong West Coast Conference. And Pepperdine at 4-1. St. Bonaventure in the NCAA tournament last in 2012. Pepperdine, they have not been in the NCAA tournament since 2002. Pick fourth in the strong West Coast Conference. St. Bonaventure fifth in a very tough Atlantic 10. And they're home Wednesday, November 30th against Siena. St. Bonaventure, 4-5 on threes in the second half. 10 of 18 beyond the arc, 56%. Overall, 23 of 47, 49%. Waves have the edge at the free throw line, 13-5. Making 13 of 17, 77%. St. Bonaventure, 5 of 5 at the line. Pepperdine, 16 of 41 from the field, 39%. They're struggling. And 5 of 12 on threes, 42%. Rebounding, Waves with the edge, 26-23. Turnovers, Pepperdine only 6. St. Bonaventure, 5. Elijah Lee to bring it in, 18 on the shot clock. Reyes right side, the Major. 11:42 to play, a lot of time left. Problem is, with the Waves thin on the bench and then using freshmen what they have, can they make a push at the end? LeSan left side, his 18-footer doesn't go. Rebound grabbed by Mobley. Transfer from Central Connecticut State. Started for 2 years, averaged 17 a game as a sophomore. Quite a find for head coach Mark Schmidt in his 10th season as head coach. In the lane, Ando, short jumper doesn't go. Rebound comes off, we get a foul. Gonna be against Reyes of Pepperdine. Three on him, five team fouls, quickly against the Waves. No, each team now with five. Nate Gehring back in. Played as a freshman as a reserve, then redshirted last year. Out of Waukee High School in Waukee, Iowa. Very athletic at 6'10". He moves well. Ball tossed in the backcourt to Mobley. 11:09 to go. This is Ando. Come off the bench for St. Bonaventure to give them a big lift in this one. Greg, high post to Obico. Obico backs in, spins, throws it up. His shot goes in. Chinonzo Obico with the lay-in, his first points of the game. He only averages two a contest. He's in there for defense and rebounding. Leon deep into Gehring, double-teamed. 63-50, Pepperdine down. Ball tipped out of bounds by Adams, Pepperdine ball. 16 on the shot clock. That zone has created some problems against the Wave. They have not seen much, but when you look at the numbers, Pepperdine has struggled on threes. They're shooting about 32%. Left side to Murray, dribbling to the key. His pass goes out of bounds, trying to find Lucinda. Wave 7 turnover. 10:28 remaining. St. Bonaventure 63, Pepperdine 50. Bonnie's in the Wave squaring off in this one. First ever meeting between the two schools, but they have that thread in common. They both had Jan Van Bredekoff as their head coach for a couple of years. Mobley in the corner makes a three. Matt Mobley with 21. And Major in the Waves down by their biggest deficit of 16, 66-50. This is Major in the corner to Gehring against that zone. Gehring dribbles back to Major on the left side. His three-pointer, and he got it from 21 feet out. Jamie Major, he has 10 in the game, 66-53. Again, there's going to be a lot of opportunities for Pepperdine as Ando's shot is short from out in front. Gehring gets it with the Waves, up the floor to Major. Major on the right sidelines, dribbling to the baseline. Adams on him to Murray, will stop and shoot. Three-pointer is good. Ramon Murray. 21 for Murray. It is 66-56. Pepperdine down by 10. A 6-0 run for the Waves. To Mobley out in front. Swinging left side to Adams. First team all-conference last year. One of the top guards in the country. NBA prospect. Ando along the baseline hits an 18-footer. Ando with 9. And it's 68-56 in favor of St. Bonaventure. Left side to Murray. Will stop and shoot a 3. That's off the mark from 21 feet. Greg with the rebound. In the front court, Adams. Back to Greg in the lane. Left-handed short jumper, no good. Rebound comes off. Ball's tied up. Murray and Obico. And quickly separated by the officials. Ando came into this game averaging 3.5 points, shooting 41% from the floor. And Ando has 9 tonight. And a key player off the bench for the Bonnies, which you need in a tournament like this. 3 games in 3 nights. 8:34 left. Pepperdine ball. Ball being tied up, so the alternating possession, Pepperdine will control. Major in the front court. Got a pretty good crowd here this evening. But you go 600-700 down the lane. Major scoop shot that misses. And the rebound by Ayeni. 6'8 freshman from Nigeria. Out in front, Adams stops and shoots. His 20-footer, no good. Greg with the rebound. Ball knocked away by Murray from behind. Head coach Mark Schmidt wanted a foul for St. Bonaventure. Nice job by Murray defending Greg down low. Helms on the left side. 7:51 to go in the second half. 68-56, St. Bonaventure. Right side to Murray with the dribble. Gets called for traveling. You know, in about 3 weeks, they won't even notice that. And right now at the start of the season, the officials have been told, watch the traveling as we get a timeout. It has been costly for the Waves. It's a big possession, trailing by 12 and much need of a basket. 68-56 Bonnies, 7:47 to play. Pepperdine led by Lamont Murray with 21. 10 for Jamie Major and Craig Lassen with 10. Chris Reyes with 8. The same Bonaventure, 13 for Jalen Adams, and 21 for Matt Mobley. Mobley comes in averaging 23 a game. Excellent shooter, 49% from the floor. And he also averages 6 rebounds a contest. and he's shooting better than 47% on three. So Matt Mobley out of Worcester, Massachusetts, an outstanding player for Bonnies. Pepperdine and Marty Wilson to our right, talking with this team. Both teams have utilized a lot of zone, and when you use zone, you can spare some energy at times, gives your players a chance to take a breather and not chasing the ball all the time. I think the Waves had to go to a zone just because Greg had been so effective early in the contest. Denzel Greg, 6'7", 215, the senior from Syracuse. The co-six-man player of the year in the Atlantic 10 last season. Greg also a top defensive player, 43 blocks. But he got off to a great start. And then terrific ball movement by St. Bonaventure. They were knocking down three, so Pepperdine went to his zone. Waves trailed by 12 in the first half, and then actually got the lead by one and trailed by two at halftime, 42-40. Waves have trailed by as many as 16 in the second period. Matt Mobley, 5 of 9 on threes. Jalen Adams, 4 of 8. 9 of 17. It's better than 51% beyond the arc. They're 11 of 21 as a team, 52% on threes. Pepperdine, 7 of 15 beyond the arc. It's an excellent 47%. Amon Murray with 21, Mobley 21. Waves pressing. Taki back in along the baseline. Ianni, his short jumper is good from 17. Ianni was 6. 70-56, same Bonaventure. They're shooting 48% for the game. It's Major out in front. Again, you put on a full-court press, you're going to use a lot of energy late. This is Murray in the corner. He's open. His three-pointer is good. Lamont Murray deep in the corner. He has 24. Long pass down the floor. Murray with the steal. Adams trying to find Ianni. Waves forced the turnover. That is the first in the second half for St. Bonaventure. Pretty impressive. Combine that with the hot shooting, especially beyond the arc, and you realize why St. Bonaventure with an 11-point lead, 70-59, 6:49 to play. You would think they'd have a bigger lead. Left side to Murray, three on the shot clock as 19-footer hits the rim. Mobley grabs the loose ball for St. Bonaventure. In the front court is Adams. That's a team that just blew out a good Central Michigan team last night, 102-71. It wasn't even that close. Adams right side, stop, 17-foot jumper's good. Adams. Adams in the game. Now with 19. Right side, Major. Waves trail 72-59. Major top of the key. Swing it to Murray. Greg right on him in that zone. Back to Gehring, 10 on the shot clock. Left side to Major, bad pass intercepted by Adams. Down the floor, Adams lays it up and in. 21 for Adams. It is 74-59. Bonnie's out in front and deep to Reyes. Swing it out to Murray on the right side. St. Bonaventure's done a nice job on Chris Reyes inside. Bonnie's are a long athletic team. Helms along the baseline, drop it off to Gehring. We're going to get an offensive foul on Helms. Waves a turnover. First on Helms. 16 fouls against Pepperdine. 5:24 to play. 74-59, St. Bonaventure. They're moving left to right in their white and brown. White jerseys, brown numbers. This is Idris Taki. Had a big game early in the first half, then got into foul trouble. Ianni inside lays it up, and in it's going to count his foul. Josh Ianni, the freshman. It's on Reyes, number 4 on him. Ianni with 8. Waves, team foul number 7. And at the line, Ianni trying to complete the 3-point play. He averages 7 points a game at the line this season, 67%. And knocks that one down. Well, it has been a big team effort by St. Bonaventure, but led by Jalen Adams and Matt Mobley. What a 1-2 combination they are. 5 minutes to go, 77-59. Major dribble drive, give it to Reyes. We get a block and a foul against St. Bonaventure.
Keep driving.
Going to be an Iani. That's his fourth. 17 fouls against St. Bonaventure will give the Waves 1-1 at the line. Chinonza Obiko back in, 6'9", senior from Nigeria. The Waves' Jeremy Major will be shooting. Adams officially with 20 in the game. Mobley 21. Ball comes up short. The front end of a 1-1. Major cannot save. It goes out of bounds. And St. Bonaventure will have possession. Biggest lead, 18-77-59. This was a two-point game at halftime. 42-40, St. Bonaventure. That's the Waves. Maybe getting a bit tired with a thin bench, but give the credit to St. Bonaventure. They played very well. Left side, Adams, he's open. A three-pointer hits the back of the rim. Long bounce to Major. Major ahead to Murray, lays it up. The ball a little bit too long, and Major couldn't time it. Bonnie's at the other end. Inside, Greg with a slam dunk. Greg with eight. 20-point advantage, St. Bonaventure, 79-59, 4:18 to play. Helms left side. Goes to Murray with the dribble top of the key. Against that zone, Major dribble in the lane. Going to get an offensive foul, throwing that right hand out. Oh, Major second. Player control, so no free throws. Pepperdine now with eight. Team fouls. Murray will come out for a rest. Elijah Lee in. So Pepperdine with Jonathan Allen also in. Jeremy Major, Elijah Lee, Knox Helms, and Chris Reyes. Reyes, transfer from Utah, played there for 2 years, a graduate senior. Actually, originally signed with St. Mary's and redshirted. Went to junior college at Citrus JC, where he's all state. Started at Utah as a sophomore, and we get a 3-second violation against St. Bonaventure. Combine the great outside shooting by St. Bonaventure and just a couple of turnovers. We have just six for the game as we get a timeout. 3:48 left. And St. Bonaventure 79, Pepperdine 59. So the Waves could go to 4-2 heading back home tomorrow, getting ready for Portland State on Sunday. And for St. Bonaventure, could improve to 3-2. And they get a week off. They'll be home against Siena on November the 30th. Big second half performance by St. Bonaventure. Obiko and Ando have come in, done a good job, especially when Taki got into foul trouble. Iani also was in foul trouble early. Waves went to a zone. Pepperdine was trailing by 12 in the first half, but the zone got him back in it. Got the Waves the lead for a couple of moments. 1-point advantage. St. Bonaventure led at halftime, though, 42-40. And it's come out strong in the second half. Their three-point shooting has been outstanding. They have cooled off a little bit, but they're still 5 of 9 in the second period, 11 of 22 threes for the game. Pepperdine, an excellent 8 of 16 on threes. Pepperdine only shooting 39% from the floor, 19 of 49. St. Bonaventure, 31 of 61, 51%. Points off turnovers, boy, that's a telling story. Waves have 11 turnovers in the game. St. Bonaventure officially was 7. However, St. Bonaventure has scored 19 points on the 11 turnovers for the Waves. Pepperdine only 4 points on the 7 turnovers by St. Bonaventure. So 19-4 off mistakes by the Waves in favor of St. Bonaventure. Waves have outshot St. Bonaventure at the line, 13-6, making 13 of 18. Bonnie, 6 of 6, rebounding, 31-30 now, St. Bonaventure. Wave 2 have 11 offensive rebounds. Mon Murray with 24, topping Pepperdine. St. Bonaventure, 21, Mobley, and Jalen Adams with 20. Adams and Mobley are combined 9 of 18 on threes. And that's their strength, and the Waves were very much aware of it going in. But easier said than done. We get a foul as the ball goes into Reyes. That'll be on Obico. Two on him. And 18 fouls against St. Bonaventure, and Chris Reyes will be at the line. And the Waves back big now, 79-59. They averaged 75 a game coming in. They missed the free throw. And the three games in three days, just a bit too much. And Bonaventure's done a nice job. Their reserves, Adams left side, Obico out in front. Adams gets it again, stops, 16-foot jumper, goes in. The basket's going to count as a foul away from the ball. Now Adams now with 22. Going to be on Allen. Obico goes down. And hopefully he's going to be okay. He's holding his right knee. For Allen, his fourth. And Obico limps off, and the young man from Nigeria will be okay. Waves with 19 fouls. Obico was the one who was fouled, so he cannot shoot. Pepperdine can choose a player to take the free throws. St. Bonaventure will get one and one after the made basket by Adams. 81-59, it will be Denzel Gregg, and the free throw is good. He came into the game making only one of five, 20%. But the Waves chose him. But he knocks that one down. He has 9 points in the game. This one's long, but Gregg gets the rebound, and there's a foul. It's going to be against Pepperdine. Jeremy Major, three on him. 10 team fouls, and now Gregg's going to get two on the double bonus. 3:08 left. 82-59, St. Bonaventure. Got themselves a hard-earned win. Free throw is short, he gets two. Denzel Gregg. Offensively, much improved over last year. Averaged 9 points and five rebounds a game this year, 12-6. He's a shot blocker. He led St. Bonaventure with 43 last year. He makes one of two. He has 10 points in the game. 83-59, St. Bonaventure. Central Michigan shot the lights out on threes a couple days ago. Bonnies do it again tonight. Reyes' jumper from 18 feet doesn't go. This is Taki with the ball in the front court. It's a nice win for St. Bonaventure. Pepperdine picked fourth in a very tough West Coast conference. And Gonzaga, St. Mary's, and Brigham Young. Up top, Adams, 13 on the shot clock. Adams just fires away. His jumper doesn't go, and the rebound grabbed. Jonathan Allen with it. Major front court, dribble into the key. Out to Helms. Helms dribble drive inside, throw it up off the glass, no good. An effort by Helms, Ianni with the rebound. 2:10 to play. Well, the Waves will fall to 4-2. 1-2 on the road, dribbling is Mobley. And a foul on the play, but it's on Allen, that's number five.
Match up, make sure you know your garden, Craig.
And it is on Jonathan Allen. Allen, the walk-on with the program for 4 years. Waves will bring in Nate Gehring and Craig Lassend with 2:06 left. Also in that West Coast Conference, Loyola Marymount, San Francisco, Santa Clara, San Diego, Portland. Outstanding mid-major conference. Mentioned the Pepperdine women lost today in New Mexico State, 75-66. Women's volleyball team Big win over number 11 San Diego, 3-1, denying the Toreros the conference championship. Brigham Young gets the title. Free throw no good by Mobley. 72% on the season. Mobley again. This one drops it in. Mobley now with 22. And it's 84-59. This tournament, four excellent mid-major teams. Lee fumbles it. Pass goes to Helms, who gets up and grabs it, throws it to Gehring, who lays it in. Gehring inside. Gehring with a couple of points. And it's 84-61. Bonnie's with it. Right side, Adams, long three-pointer, hits the back of the rim. And Major grabs over Pepperdine. Major in the front court, out to Helms, top of the key. His three-point shot doesn't go. It goes out of bounds. And St. Bonaventure will have the ball. Tariq Coburn will come in as Jalen Adams goes out. Coburn, a 6'5 freshman from Rochester, New York. Cardoso High School, he was an all-state player, averaged 19 points a game. So if you're head coach Mark Schmidt, you can use the bench. Here's Mobley taking this shot, blocked by Gehring, gets it back and puts it up and in. Mobley with 24. The Bonnies, they're going to have to wait and see. About later tonight, Central Michigan and Little Rock, and the Bonnies will be rooting for Central Michigan to win tonight to give St. Bonaventure the championship in this Lone Star Showcase. 86-61, 107 to play. Helms right side, dribble drive against Ando, just in. His shot rejected by Akizi, and the Bonnies will bring it in the front court. And it's a big second half by St. Bonaventure. It was a 42-40 game at the break. In the corner, long three-pointer is good by Coburn. Just into the game, the left-hander drops in the three. And we're down to 41 seconds, 89-61. I think the Waves just ran out of gas. 3 games, 3 days, a thin bench. Gehring with a slam dunk. Gehring now with 8. And the Waves down 89-63, 30 seconds remaining. Shot clock a couple of seconds ahead of the game clock. And St. Bonaventure in this first ever meeting between the two schools. Very impressive. The number 5 team in the Atlantic 10. Mobley to Coburn.
No bucket.
And the Bonnies will just run the clock out. Waves will get 2 seconds when they get possession, unless they put it up. Down to 5 on the game clock. And the shot clock expires. It shows 1.4 seconds left. 89-63. Waves will get it. Time for a quick touch and just fire up a long shot. But St. Bonaventure, 89, Pepperdine 63. You can put a couple seconds back on, and the Waves will let it run out, and that is it. Final score, St. Bonaventure 89, Pepperdine 63. Pepperdine goes to 4-2, 1-2 on the road. St. Bonaventure 3-2 on the season, and they're 3-1 on the road. And St. Bonaventure 2-1 in this tournament. Pepperdine will finish 1-2. First ever meeting between the two schools. Both teams congratulating each other. The Waves without Amadi Udini, their starting point guard. Starting forward in Cameron Edwards. And just not enough to take them through 3 games in 3 days. And the Waves come up short on this one. While you're listening to WavesCast, and Pepperdine Athletics would like to extend its thanks to the following businesses for their support this season. The Parking Spot, Coca-Cola, Gold Coast Tours, Dukes of Malibu, the Warner Center Marriott, the Anza Calabasas Hotel, Chick-fil-A, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, National Car Rental, Primetime Shuttle, and Wells Fargo. For Pepperdine, they were led by Lamont Murray, 24 points. He had 16.